Well, with all the big security breaches over the past year, you might be wondering if your credit cards are safe heading into the holiday shopping season.
CBS 4's Suzanne McCarroll takes a look at the new technology that's protecting your purchases.
Mahesh Patil plans to pay for his groceries using his smartphone.
It's kind of the new way of making payments, you know, so I figure I might as well get on it now.
Apple Pay and Google Wallet are the newest payment methods. You load your credit and debit cards onto your phone, then you can use the phone to pay. All you have to do is hold your phone above the terminal and the transaction is automatic. Apple Pay uses temporary numbers called tokens. They disappear the minute the purchase goes through.
The token is coming right back to verify that the card being presented is actually real.
Steve Fox is a cybersecurity expert. He says while the token system is beneficial for protecting against fake cards, you still can be vulnerable.
In the next 3 years, you'll hear about an Apple Pay breach.
For Patel, the technology didn't work on this purchase.
I don't know what happened today, but I had a card as a backup, so I was able to pay.
Glitches in the system and limited participation by retailers keep Apple Pay and Google Wallet from becoming more common. Patel sees a day when they'll be standard.
Yeah, I'd love to be able to get rid of my credit cards and my wallet.
I don't see it anytime soon.
Steve Montross is the head of CPI Card Group, one of the largest makers of credit cards in the nation. He says his business has tripled in the last year as he makes the new chip and PIN cards.
Because the information that's on that card is encrypted, it's on that chip, and so it's not possible for a fraudster to then take that information off the chip and create a duplicate card.
Card companies are scrambling to replace magnetic cards with cards that have more secure chip technology and require a PIN number for verification. These cards have been used for years in Europe and have reduced fraud by up to 80%. The U.S. has been slow to make the transition.
The card brands and the financial institutions have chosen to accept the risk instead of spend the money to move over to these more secure chip and PIN systems.
Even with chip and PIN technology, your account information is still on a server and therefore could be vulnerable. Suzanne McCarroll, CBS 4 News.
So experts say the absolute safest way to protect your information is to pay with cash.